Hello everyone. We were discussing about issue of shares by the company. So we have discussed here so far issue of shares at par or face value, issue of shares at premium, then oversubscription, forfeiture of shares, calls in arrears, calls in advance, and after that forfeiture of shares issued at par. Then forfeiture of shares issued at a premium. All these things we have discussed. So if anybody of you have any doubt, you can refer all those videos. So today we are going to see a new topic. That is reissue of the forfeited shares. So in the last class we discussed about forfeiture of shares. So such a forfeited shares, that means the cancelled shares we will collect back. So that shares are there with us. These shares we are going to reach. The company is going to reach. So that is what we are going to discuss today. Reissue of forfeited shares. Reissue of forfeited shares. See, this reissue of forfeited shares, so at that time, after forfeiture, these shares if reissue, we have to make certain journal entries. These shares will be reissued to some other persons or public. Okay, so at that time, we have to make a journal entry. Normally, reissue will be done. That means the money for the reissue will be collected in lump sum. May not be collected in installment. It will be collected in lump sum. So we have to write the journal entry for reissue. That is the first one. So if reissued at a par, company can reissue shares at a par. So if reissue at par, if company reissue the shares at a par, the journal entry will be Bank account debtor, we can say that right here. This is amount received. Amount received on reissue. To share capital. That is, we can say that it is paid up capital. Paid up when? Okay. This entry we are going to explain. Suppose a company issued some shares. Say company issued 50,000 shares at the rate of rupees 10. It was issued not on reissue. Before that, company issued 50,000 shares. So for that application money was rupees 2. Allotment money rupees 3. First call again rupees 2. Second call the remaining. That means 3 rupees. Okay. So at that time a shareholder holding 4,000 shares, let us take 4,000 shares, did not pay first and second call money. These shares are forfeited and going to reissue. Okay, so what would be the forfeiture entry at that time? Let us write that forfeiture entry at that time. So we have to write share capital debtor. How much? 4,000 into 10. That means 40,000. That is 4,000 into 10. Isn't it? To forfeited shares. Forfeited shares means
how much he had paid. These two first and second call not paid, that means he has paid application and allotment money. That means 4000 into 5. 4000 into 5, 20,000 he paid. And not paid first call. First call not paid, how much? 4000 into 2. 8000 not paid, and like that, second call also not paid. How much? 4000 into 3. 12,000. So how much he paid? 20,000 only he paid for forfeited shares. Okay, this is the forfeited. Okay, these shares are forfeited and reissued. These shares are reissued for rupees 10 paid up. Reissued for rupees 10 paid up. That means total money should be, that means the revalue time or reissue time, the amount that is supposed to collect from the new shareholder is 10 per share. Okay, so how much he has to pay? 4000 into 10 that is collected from him. So how much? 40,000 will be collected from him. And share capital will be 10 rupees into 4000. 4000 is the share, so that also 40,000. Okay, then this entry here, it is not over. Now this one, the entry after passing this, we already collected some money for future, for future shares are there, that is our profit. This profit should be transferred to capital reserve. This profit should be transferred to capital reserve. That means the account balance should be transferred to capital reserve. For that, a general raise to be needed. So that is for transferring share for future account or forfeited shares account to capital reserve. Okay, that entry we have to write here. This is also very very important entry. That is, entry is forfeited shares debtor forfeited shares account debtor to capital reserve. How much? This entire money, 20,000, will be transferred. Okay, this is the entry here for transferring share for future account to capital reserve. Now here, suppose this is issued at par. This is issued at par. So at that time, we have told that rupees 10 paid up, we told. Suppose if it is not for 10 paid up. So how much it is? So for example, it is reissued for rupees 9 paid up. Rupees 9 paid up. Okay. That means it is not fully paid up, it is for 9 paid up. And they have to pay 9 rupees for 9 paid up. So here it is 4000 into 9, 36,000. Here also, how much? 36,000. That is why it is written here as paid up, not written capital value or face value. It is paid up value. How much the new shareholder is asked to pay in total, that is called paid up. Then another case, second case, if reissued at a discount. Reissued at a discount. See, as per the Indian Companies Amendment Act 2013, shares cannot be issued at a discount.
Shares cannot be issued at a discount. It can be issued at the face value or at a premium. But when we issue or when we reissue a forfeited share, when we reissue forfeited shares, that can be issued at a discount. Fresh issue cannot be issued at a discount, but at the time of reissue, it can be issued at a discount.
So then what will be the journal entry at that time? That time also we will write the journal entry, bank account debtor. What is that? That is amount received. That is amount received. Okay. Then amount received. Next entry here it should be to share capital. Share capital. What it is? What is that share capital? Paid up value. Okay. Suppose this is issued here. This is issued or reissued at rupees 10. 10 at rupees 10 at a discount of 2 rupees per share. Its face value or the value of issue is 10, but now it is issued at a discount. So here 4000 into 10, that means 40,000 is the total money. But now how much he has to pay? 4000 into 8, because it is at a discount. That means he has to pay 32,000 rupees. So what is that difference? That is discount. That discount will be our loss. It will be a loss on reissue. That loss will be deducted from the forfeiture income. That means from the original shareholder we have received some income. From that income, this reissue discount will be deducted. So that amount will be debited to share forfeiture account. So we can write here forfeited shares debtor. That means amount of reissue discount. How much? 4000 into 2. 8000. Okay, this discount will be deducted from forfeiture. That means forfeiture income. So shares can be issued or reissued at a discount, but on one condition, that is very very important. That condition is that the reissue discount should not be more than the amount originally collected from the shareholder, or reissue discount should not be more than the amount collected from the original shareholder. So amount collected from the original shareholder is 20,000. So we can give discount up to a maximum of 20,000. It should not be 20,001 rupee also. Okay. Reissue discount should not be more than the amount collected from the original shareholder. So in exam time, a question can be expected that what can be the maximum amount of discount on reissue? What can be the maximum amount of discount on reissue? What can be the maximum amount? The maximum amount of the discount on reissue can be the amount collected from the original shareholder. It should not be beyond that. Okay. So that is regarding issued shares issued at a discount. Suppose if it is given here that shares are issued at rupees 9. At rupees 9 called up at a discount of 2 rupees. At rupees 9 called up at a discount of 2 rupees. Then what will be the amount here? Here it is, it will be 9. That means 36,000. Here it is 4000 into how much? 2. 2 only. 2 rupees discount. So 8000. Here how much will be collected? 7 rupees will be collected. Okay. How much?
28,000. Okay, 28,000 will be collected.
So this is regarding share issue of ratio of shares at a discount. Now let us see the third condition. And before that, one more thing is there. See, reissue time discount is how much? 8,000. That is to be deducted from the forfeiture. So, but now actual forfeiture account balance how much? 40,000 minus 8,000. How much? 32,000 only. So that 32,000 only, sorry, 20,000 was there. From that 8,000 is deducted. So remaining how much? 12,000. That means here 20,000 was there minus 8,000. Now it became 12,000. So 12,000 only can be transferred to capital reserve. That means the forfeiture account balance will be, forfeiture shares balance is now 12,000 only. That will be transferred to capital reserve. Okay. Then let us see the third one, third situation. If reissued at a premium, if reissued at a premium, these shares can be reissued at a premium also. So at that time, what would be the journal entry? So before that, let us see that situation. It says that shares are reissued at rupees 10 per share for rupees 12 per share. So the paid up value is 10 per share. Paid up value is rupees 10. But amount will be collected 12 rupees. That means reissued at a premium. So how much the shareholder has to give? Bank account debtor, how much he has to give? Amount paid 4,000 into 12. How much? 48,000. Okay, 2, share capital, how much paid up value, how much? 4,000 into 10, that is 40,000. Remaining 2 rupees shortage is there in the credit side, that what to do? Should be transferred to securities premium account. Securities premium reserve account. How much? 8,000. That means 4,000 into 4,000 into 2. Okay. Now how much will be transferred to forfeiture capital reserve? How much amount of forfeiture will be transferred to capital reserve? Same. This total 20,000 fully we can transfer. 20,000 will be transferred. Okay. So this is regarding issue of shares or reissue of shares. Clear now? Any doubt is there? Okay. So now we are going to discuss the next topic, reissue of shares which are not fully. That means here 4,000 shares were forfeited and all the 4,000 shares were reissued. Now let us see next case, that is but partly reissued. Okay, reissued shares are reissued partly, not fully. That's what we are going to discuss now. Now we are discussing partial reissue of shares. Shares are not fully reissued. Part of that forfeited shares are reissued. Let us discuss the situation with the same
amount of forfeiture. This 4,000 shares we have already forfeited. Out of this part we are going to reissue. 4,000 shares are forfeited. Now we are going to reissue 1,000 shares. 1,000 shares. Full amount, full shares are not reissued. Then what will be the GNR entry at that time? Okay.
So first we can say reissued at par. Reissue at par or face value. GNR entry bank account debtor. That means reissue 1,000 shares at rupees 10. What will be the journal entry? Bank account debtor to share capital. As usual, you know that bank account means the money received by the money received from reissue. So how much reissued? 1,000 into 10. That means 10,000 rupees. Here also 10,000 rupees. Okay. Now what is the next GNR entry? That forfeiture account is to be transferred into capital reserve. So let us see what will be the transfer of share forfeiture. Let us see that GNR entry. Forfeited shares account debtor to capital reserve. How much can be transferred? That's what we are going to see here. Here reissue right here. See, 20,000 was there in total. 20,000 we had in total. So that was for how many shares? 4,000 shares. Now how much is reissuing? 1,000 shares are reissuing. Its proportionate forfeiture amount only can be transferred to capital reserve. Why? Because we have 3,000 remaining with us. This 3,000 shares in future we may reissue at a discount also. So at that time we should not face any loss. So how much is reissuing now? Its proportionate should be transferred. So we will get how much? 5,000 we will get. This 5,000 will be transferred. You understood how it is? 20,000 was there with us. That was for 4,000 shares. Then what is for 1,000 shares? So 5,000 will be transferred. Okay. That is the situation when it is reissued at par. The next case. Reissue at a discount. Reissued at a discount. So reissued 1,000 shares at the rate of rupees 1,000 shares of rupees 10 each at a discount of rupees 2 rupees discount. So partial reissue at a discount. So let us see the journal entry. Bank account debtor. The old journal entry only. Okay. Bank account debtor. Then forfeited shares debtor. Forfeited shares debtor to share capital. Bank account debtor, we know 1,000 into how much we will get? 2 rupees discount. So how much he will pay? 8 rupees he will pay. So here it is 8,000. forfeited shares discount 1000 into 2, that means 2000. Okay, 2000 debit. So we can write here 2000 to capital, 1000 into 10, that means 10,000 rupees. 10,000. Okay, that's clear. Now, how much will be transferred to share forfeiture? So that you have to see carefully, that we had 20,000 with us total. That is out of the total number of forfeited shares. Then what will be for reissued shares? Then that also it is at a discount. So from that, discount on reissue should be deducted. How much? 2000 should be deducted. So this is the method of calculation. So that we can write what is the equation. That equation can be deducted, or we can show that this equation here, forfeited shares account transferred to capital reserve is equal to, that we are going to calculate. How? Total forfeiture income. Total forfeiture income divided by total forfeited shares into reissued shares. Okay, from that minus reissue discount. So that is what is calculated here. Total forfeiture income divided by total forfeited shares into reissued shares minus reissue discount. Okay, understood? So that only will be the amount. So here it is, we will get 5000 minus 2000. How much will be transferred? 3000 will be transferred. Understood? So in this case 3000 will be transferred. So this is reissue at a discount. This is very important thing. You should not confuse. You have to study it clearly. You have to understand it clearly. Okay? Reissue discount will be deducted from this proportionate reissued shares for future account. Okay? Then last one more thing is there. Reissue at a premium. Shares reissued at a premium. What will be the journal entry? Bank account debtor. So here it says that ratio of 1000 shares of rupees 10 each at a premium of rupees 3. It is reissuing at a premium of rupees 3. So what will be the journal entry? Bank account debtor. Reissuing at 3 rupees each. So 4000 into how much? 13. Okay. So 52,000. Understood? So 52,000 is the total amount collected to share capital, 4000 into 10, how much? 40,000 to securities premium reserve How much? 12,000. Okay. So like this, the journal entry will be written at the time when shares are reissued at a premium. Okay. Then here for future entry will be how much will be transferred? Here again, how much? 5,000 will be there. Here in the case, 5,000 will be there. Same way. Okay. Earlier, here we have deducted 2,000, we have deducted here in the last case. Now this 2,000 need not be deducted. So 5,000 will be transferred. Okay. Is it clear to all? So today we have discussed about reissue of shares. That means full reissue and partial reissue. Full reissued at par, then discount and at premium, and partial reissue also at par, discount and premium. Is it clear to all? So you have to refer such a type of problems from your reference book and solve it. Okay. Thank you for listening.